happening, everybody, and welcome to another Smokers Conversations episode where we record conversations that we were going to have anyway and upload it to the internet. I ran out of air there. That was a lot of air. I'm one of the hosts, Eddie, along with my bro with the most below, Sheps. How's it going, bro?
It's going okay. I mean, you got my hopes up a little bit there.
Oh, you was like, yes, he's going to die. I'm going to do this by myself. Well, f*** it. I'm with you forever. A lot of swear words right there in the beginning of the video. That's going to have to be bleeped out. Today, we are going to be talking about Xbox, specifically a console that was cancelled, slash rumoured, slash never come again, but then coming again, and it's called the Xbox Lockhart. Do you remember this console? Lay the groundwork for the guys that don't know what the Xbox Lockhart is.
So, at the beginning, pre-E3 announcement, there were rumours that Xbox was going to do their, like, premium, the full...
Full curry, two chilies, you
absolutely
know,
fully, yeah. The good. Full spice, yeah. The Scarlet. As well as a secondary console called Project Lockhart, which is going to be, like, budget-friendly.
Yeah, one chili, korma, light
exactly.
For everyone.
And then at E3, basically they said, here's our console, it's called the Scarlet. And everybody said, hold on a minute, what about the Lockhart? And they said, we never said we were doing two consoles. We never said we were doing a budget version.
Exactly. Phil Spencer himself in interviews afterwards was like, we never said we were going to do a second console.
True.
That is true, yes.
Kind of. Is true. They did not ever confirm. They did not ever confirm that they were doing two consoles.
That's true.
And then they confirmed that they were doing one flagship model.
Exactly. They said in holiday 2020, there will be one console. Yeah. Released. However, Jason Schreier of Kotaku has had four separate sources confirm to him, including one of them being a developer who is actually working on the device. He trusts them, and Jason Schreier's name carries a lot of weight, so he must trust him quite well. Apparently, that the Lockhart is real, and apparently that is coming alongside the Xbox Scarlet, a budget version of the Scarlet for people who don't want to pay for the full 4K amazing balls and curry sauce thing talking about. This console, just to give you the highlighted details here, apparently going to be target resolution of around about 1440p, so people maybe who don't,
good.
It's pretty good anyway. 60 frames per second is a word that they're chucking around a lot. SSD storage, no disc drive in it, so it's going to be
another
the sad edition, another sad edition. And I think one of the guys in the chat as well mentioned that, like, oh, Xbox are doing another sad edition. That's
talking
great.
About the chat, if you want to join in with the community and talk to us even more,
yes,
in the link down there,
you should definitely head down there. It's an epic place to be. It does have Diogo there, which is not really a good thing, but
you gotta watch out for that guy while you're down there as well. There's a couple of things you can click. There's a red subscribe button, you want to click that, and then there's a thumbs up, which you want to make a nice friendly blue.
Oh yeah,
just blue, it just helps. It helps go. All of us. You feel good. You did a thumbs up. We feel good because we got a thumbs up.
It's all great.
We won't do an end of the year conversations like, rewind.
Oh god,
and that's a threat. We'll do it.
We will. I feel like Death Stranding, where it's like. There you go. So that's the console that they've laid out right there. It's supposed to be a more budget version. Supposed to be slightly less powerful. Supposed to be digital only.
Yep.
Digital only kind of makes sense because they're going for a lot of services, Microsoft, at the moment. However, it's not the world that we live in yet.
No. Digital only is not where we're at, because the other thing is there's movies. Like, movies are a thing.
Yeah.
Box sets are still a thing, and I like buying the box sets, and even though I do buy a lot of my movies on Amazon Prime, Prime Video I mean, so it's just there so I can log in wherever, I still buy the Steelcase box set.
Exactly. Walshy as well in the Discord is saying, a discless console isn't something that interests me as someone who likes owning physical media, but I definitely understand why, and it's a good move by Microsoft given the amount of people that purely play digital. There are people that play digital, I don't know about purely, but there are people that play digital, and this might be appealing to them. And also, there was that rumor as well that they were going to be doing a service where you could take your physical game to a Microsoft store and then trade it into a digital version. However, that does lose a bit of value as well. So, like, because you can't trade that back in anywhere.
Exactly.
You're trading for a permanent code for no extra
reward, yeah.
And one other thing as well, for people who do like digital, I understand that you have a preference and you don't want to have to go through, like, boxes and stuff like that.
It's convenient.
It's convenient. However, Stadia at the moment, the very first brand new game launched on Stadia, and it's $10 more expensive than it is for any other platform, even the digital stores on other places as well. So if this was the future, you're going to be locked into a pretty expensive future. So
yeah, and there's no, you can't like, oh, I finished this, it wasn't my favorite, I'll trade it in and get something older that I missed.
Exactly.
You can't do that.
Anyway, that's the discless part of it. How do you feel about a slightly cheaper console possibly being out there?
I just don't... It's Microsoft that's the problem, not the two consoles.
Yeah.
They have given us so little... Like, we... This guy's talking to devs. Let's see some of the dev kits.
Mm-hmm.
We haven't seen dev kits. We haven't seen the console. We haven't seen anything.
Whereas we've seen pictures of the PS5 right. dev
and
kit already.
And it might look nothing like that when the PS5 comes out. But I don't care. I've seen something. It's got my excitement up.
We know it exists. Exactly. Stuff like that.
That's one thing. We haven't actually seen anything of the Scarlet, let alone the Lockhart. The Lockhart has had this weird life cycle of, it's a rumor. They're going to do it. No, we're not going to do it. Oh, okay. They're not going to do it. Wait, we are doing it. Well, which is it? I'd like to know. I'm in a position where I used to be the Xbox fanboy,
mm-hmm.
and they've screwed me so hard, so consistently, that I kind of want them to fail, because I'm a jilted lover. They're my ex, right? I'm wondering if this isn't a thing where they say, we never said we were doing two consoles, and everybody came out and said, well, hold on a minute, we've heard all this stuff about two consoles, and it's been scrapped, and they've misinterpreted, you said you were doing it for, we want it, and it's going to be a huge blunder, because I don't know that it's a appropriate, really.
It doesn't seem to fit the market that we have right now.
It's not appropriate to bring out a minus when you're coming out and it's not what we want.
What's extra weird about this as well is that apparently the power of it is going to be around about a PlayStation 4 Pro level, which is really weird because they've got an Xbox One X, which is more powerful than the PlayStation 4 Pro.
Yeah.
So you're going to offer people something that's crappier than the console that you have than the current flagship, which is going to be older at that point. So you're going back in time over there.
It doesn't make sense. I don't see how it's appropriate.
Because
again, by the time next gen comes out,
mm-hmm.
what do you think the retail price of a brand spanking new PS4 Pro or Xbox One X S super sad, lonely, and depressed model is? Right?
that name.
Right. Like, it's not going to be much, and you're going to get similar power, and we know for a fact a lot of these games are backwards compatible.
Yeah.
Why are you going to buy an Xbox Scarlet Minus? What's the point? I don't know where it fits.
Yeah.
It would have fit a year ago. It would have been a banging thing to release a year ago.
Yeah.
Instead of the Xbox One X.
And that's really, that's my personal problem with it as well. Because for developers, for people that don't know, when you're trying to develop for multiple systems, it's a pain in the butt.
Yes.
Especially when really it should be one system, but you've decided to make two systems out of it. So when they come to develop, say, the next Call of Duty, they need to then go, okay, so this needs to work on a PlayStation. We know the architecture. Cool. Needs to work on an Xbox. Oh, shit. But that particular scene doesn't work on the crappier version.
Yeah.
What the hell are we going to do? Okay, we're going to have to sacrifice now. And whether they sacrifice that from all versions, that could totally be possible.
Yeah.
You're screwing everybody by making a crappier version because they have to go for the lowest common denominator.
Porting isn't as simple as just saying you build one and then copy paste and then turn a setting down. It doesn't work that way.
No.
I mean, I'm a very experienced games developer, so I can take first-hand experience.
Mm-hmm. All the games that you've done, what were they called again?
You know them all.
Jesus Simulator. I'm going to play that. I swear to God, we've been talking about that. But anyway, don't get off topic.
Fuck. It's just not that simple.
Yeah.
It isn't as simple as doing that. And like you said, so we're currently in a point in gaming where it is us, the console master race, that's holding back the games.
Exactly.
Right? PC games can't take the next jump forward until we come out with next gen.
We need to catch up to them for them to be able to go further.
Right, exactly. To leapfrog. Why would you start out limping?
Yeah.
In this marathon, right? Because what do we think the life of a console is? 6 to 8 years,
something like that. Yeah.
6 to 8 years marathon, and you're gonna start out next gen with a console that's less powerful than your current gen.
Yeah.
How does that work? And if it's backwards compatible, why am I gonna, seriously, why would you buy an Xbox Lockhart when you can buy an Xbox One S that's gonna tank in price, get a brand new one for way less?
Well, let me give you a little comment here from Diogo, because he does bring up one point, which is the only point I feel like is the one that's going to make sense. He goes, I can see the market for it. It will probably sell, especially since it's cheaper, which is, when something is cheaper, it does sell more. That is a proof. In fact, money drives a lot of reasons for a lot of people.
Absolutely.
And he goes, given that digital is becoming even more popular, personally, I still wouldn't buy it because I don't prefer digital and I would rather go for the cheaper upfront cost. Will be better in the long run, as digital games tend to be £5 to £10 more expensive than physical. What would the saving be? £100? You will end up be paying more per game over the next couple of years. So saving £100 upfront, even if it is that much more cheaper, you're not going to be saving it in the long run because you're paying more for your video games digitally anyway.
That's the way I look at it. Now, maybe you buy one game a year.
Yeah.
But then are you going to buy a new console? Do you know what I mean? I don't see who this is for. And if it has no disk drive, which again, I understand from a budget perspective,
mm-hmm.
it can't do... your favorite DVD. It can't do those home movies that granddad burnt onto a CD-ROM back in the day, right? It can't do that stuff. So it has less functionality. It's less powerful than previous gen.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, the Xbox One S, if it comes out, it's more powerful. It's got a disc drive, and most of the games, at least to begin with, are backwards compatible. Why would you get the Lockhart?
Even now, I was almost tempted, but it was the stupid part of me that was going mad. I was tempted to buy an Xbox One X. The price of them dropped down to £299 from
£499. That's not a bad price.
And it had a couple of games in there, and I was like, this is the best console in terms of graphics at the moment. I could afford that. But then I was thinking to myself, wait a minute, it's been like less than a year and we're going to get brand new consoles. That's a stupid investment.
Not only that, you actually have an Xbox One, don't you?
I do, yes. My Blu-ray player right downstairs.
I was going to say, that's what I was leading up to. How many games do you have on it?
Zero.
Did you get Game Pass?
I didn't.
Actually, do you even have a controller for it?
The controller that it came with, that was the only thing I got.
Have you used it or do you use the remote?
I just used it to start video. That's it.
Yeah, exactly. And that's not because it's a bad console. In fact, the Xbox One S is a pretty decent console, right? Yeah. There's just not a lot to play on it. Not a lot that's Xbox exclusive is worth playing.
Yeah, that's the thing. They have games and they have a lot of games on Game Pass and whatnot, but not a reason why you would buy Xbox. That's the thing.
Exactly. They just made a good console.
Yeah. Darth Nirok as well, he hit the nail on the head as well. He goes, cheaper version of Xbox is good for those trying to game on a budget, I guess. That's the reason why people would buy this. But then again, it brings us back to the thing we said before. The Xbox One X will still be around, I'm sure.
Yeah.
And what price would that be? Let's say it drops down to $250, seeing as it's $299 now. Is this console going to be cheaper than $250?
No. No way.
Then what's the point?
So the other thing is, gaming on a budget, why aren't I going to go look at Nintendo?
Yeah, fucking great games over there.
Amazing stuff that you can only get on that platform.
Exactly.
And it's portable. Yeah. If I get a Switch, I get an ultimate Game Boy as well.
Yeah. I will say there's one person that goes against us, and it's Nightmare Fuel with a PH. And he goes, we are the whales. That's right, we are.
We are the whales.
He goes, I don't see why people are complaining about this. It's not like you're forced to buy it. It's just available for people, what they want for next gen gaming for a cheaper price. Personally, I don't think it's something I'm interested in getting. I'll probably opt for the higher cost, more powerful Xbox Scarlett. That's the thing. We're not trying to bag on it as in like, oh, why are people allowed to have the choice? Yeah. That's not what we're saying. But it is going to have a domino effect, A, on development as well, and B, it's just like the SAD edition where, who is this for?
Let's be clear. Like you said, it's not that we're upset that people have the choice.
Yeah.
There is the curiosity of like, well, who is their target demo? Who do they think is actually going to want this thing, right? Mm. With the other options of the Xbox One S or the Scarlett, and that's only in that same family. They've got enough competition in their own family, let alone the PS5, and whatever Nintendo comes out with next, or even a Switch today, right?
Yep.
And then, as well as having the knock-on effect for games, because developers have to make a turned-down version, and eventually they're going to say, look, we can't turn it down enough for it to work on these current things. It needs to be developed lower, which is going to hold back games, which is why we wanted a next-gen in the first place. Also, as much as I don't like Microsoft, because they burnt me.
Mm.
If a competing console isn't there, it allows Sony not to put their best foot forward.
They get just lazy and they just lean back and they're like...
Oh, exactly. And without the Xbox competition, we don't get games like God of War.
Yeah.
Right? We don't get consoles like the PS4 versus the Xbox One.
You can see it even within Sony. So like back on the PS3, there were crazy games that you would never see today. Yeah. But because they've got the heavy hitters like Last of Us, the God of Wars, the Horizons, the Spider-Mans, they're like, well, why do we need to experiment and go all crazy and whatnot? So even within themselves, they're like, they've started to get a little bit laid back.
Exactly.
Now, granted, we're still getting amazing games. So how bad is it really?
Right, exactly.
But you don't get crazy games, and that's evidence of it right now.
We need the competition. You need competition. If there's nothing that they have to fear that is going to drive people away from them, they have no incentive to keep you there. They just have a monopoly on it, and that ends up being bad for us, the gamers.
Yeah. Ashton, the lad with the final comment here, he comes in with another fucking long paragraph from what it goes here. Xbox bad. PS4 good. Caveman, I mean, right there.
A bit long-winded. But generally agreed.
Generally, I was not with him in the middle. I dipped a little bit.
I know what you mean.
But then it got back up afterwards.
He lost me with the punctuation there.
Right
comma.
There. That little comma.
I was like, I was like, oh, and then he brought it back.
There you go. Managed to steer the ship home. Good on you, Ashton. Good on you. All right, that's all the shit that we've got to talk about when it comes to the Xbox Lockhart. I'm interested to see what happens. Hopefully in like February time, we should be getting reveal events for both PlayStation and Xbox.
Yeah.
It'll be interesting to see what happens. I'll catch you in the next one, bros.
See you in the next one. That's good.